Qlik Dork back again, and today we're going to be talking about the fact that Databricks recently released a REST API interface so that you could call their LLMs. How fun is that? You know, I had to jump on that. We're going to be looking specifically at how we can create a new deployment endpoint. That involves taking one of their foundational models, but creating your own version of it so that you can call it. Then we're going to look at how we can make a very basic call. I'm just going to ask for a little dad joke. There you go. Then we'll look at the real business use case that I know you're much more interested in. Finally, we're going to start looking at how we really call that deployment that we create in order to have that business case taken care of. And I'm going to show you at the end how I created an advanced analytics connection to call what I'm going to call in their REST endpoint. Are you ready to have fun? Because I sure am. Let's get going. Although it's not really the point of this video, I wanted to show you a couple of the features for creating server endpoints that Databricks has provided that I really appreciate. First thing is it's super easy. All I have to do is come in here, give it a name for whatever that might be, and of course I'm going to use the Qlik Dork name all the time. I get to choose what that server endpoint would be from one of their foundational models. And then I've got a couple of other options, and this is really the point of why I wanted to take just a few seconds to show you these things. One, you can enable tracking of it so that you can see the audit for who's been using this, what's been going on with that. One that I really think is cool is this AI guardrails here. It enables you to provide some security for what those models are that would be able to be consumed. I'm going to go ahead and switch and show you. Here's just a couple of those things. It prevents content about violence and hate, sexual content, criminal planning, guns and weapons, suicide and self-harm. And you turn that on and it would do something like this, where if somebody asks, how can you teach me how to rob a bank? It's going to say, yeah, no, I'm not able to do that because Databricks has implemented this AI governance for safety for those endpoints. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm not actually going to create a new one now because that's not the point of this video. I'm going to back up to just show you that we've already created a couple of these endpoints. The one I'm going to use in my demonstration today is this Databricks MetaLlama 3.1 70 billion instruct model. That's their foundational model. When I deploy this and I have my own endpoint, my data is going into training my deployment of that model. It is not training the MetaLlama 3.1 70 billion instruct model for everyone else in the world. It is my version of that model. After I create these things, I end up with a URL that I'm able to call. And so that URL is there. You can go ahead and click for their REST API documents so that you understand how to call that. What I would do is simply copy that to the clipboard. And what I'm going to show you is how in an automation, I'm able to just make that call. So I simply have a really basic Qlik application automation here. One thing I've done is created a variable for the key. The key is my API key that I would create in my Databricks profile so that I can make that call. So I'm not going to show you that because it's my key. All I have to do is paste that URL in here. It's a post method, and they take some parameters that you can pass them. One is about the token. So you can define on a case-by-case basis how many tokens you're going to allow to use, because that's how you're going to be charged for these things. Their content is kind of nested in that they have these messages, because I can pass multiple questions if I choose. I have to give each thing a role, and I say, hey, I'm the user, and here's the content. I want you to tell me a dad joke about my income. And then that key that we've defined as a variable can be passed here as the authorization. So as I call this URL, it's passing my token to know, hey, this is Dalton. Go ahead and answer this question. if it's somebody else just copies that URL and you try to access this, you're not going to get an answer because you don't have that key in there that's allowed to call this model. So all I'm going to go ahead and do here is press run. And it made that call, and I can come down here and I can see, hey, I see what I passed it, and then it shows me the output from their REST API, and I get an answer. Why did your income go to therapy? Because it was feeling a little taxed and wanted to work through some withdrawal issues. That's probably pretty much a great dad joke about my income, as a matter of fact. Come on, we're not really just going to end this video by calling a REST API and asking for a dad joke. That was just to show you the very basics of how we got things started. What we really want to do is get business insights from that collective wisdom of the world that is stored in these Databricks LLMs that they're surfacing as their models and that we've now deployed as our own model that we can work with then. So if I were looking at my screen visually, I can see information about billings. I can see information about net profit. I can look at customer details and so on and so on. And you get the idea. There could be a lot of dimensions, a lot of measures visualized, and that's fantastic. And I could spend all day walking through, navigating things. You know how ClickSense works. But I can take advantage now of this deployment to ask for things like, can you give me 5 questions I could ask about the relationships hiding in this data that I might miss if I were focusing on just one fact or the other at a time? And Databricks comes back and gives me a phenomenal answer that would augment my own understanding of the data that I'm looking at visually here. So I think this is great. Now your question is obviously going to be like, hey, wait a second here, Qlik Dork. How did you jump from asking a plain question about a dad joke to being able to get answers that are integrated with the data? And oh, by the way, if I were to filter to things, notice that it is responsive. I'm going to use an automation that's very much like the other one, with a few exceptions. I've got the variable key there, yay! I call the URL, same exact URL, but notice here that I've now changed this. So instead of hard coding 1,024 tokens, I'm accepting the number of tokens. And notice here that it's converting this tokens to use from the start block into a number. I use the start block to get the role. I use the start block to get the prompt. And you're going to be saying, now, wait a second. The start block doesn't have those things. Well, you're right. A start block normally starts out with nothing. It gets those pieces passed to it. And all I needed to do here was mark that this automation is triggered rather than manual, like I showed you in the other block. And notice here that it comes down and it gives me the automation URL that I'm going to call, and it gives me the token that I'm going to use to make that call. So in my application, what I've got is I created an advanced analytics connection that calls this Qlik application automation. And it really super easy to set up. I simply say, hey, give me this fake name for a table. Give me this name for the response. And so that automation is there like any server-side type of extension. And if I were to edit the sheet and look at this, I can see that this output block here is a master visualization. And if I go edit the properties for this master visualization, you'll see that I'm simply calling my endpoint script eval string, and I'm calling this app automation. And then here's the cool thing, if you didn't know, as you call an automation, I can pass whatever fields I want. So I pass 1024 as the tokens to use field, I pass user as the role, and I pass whatever variable is assigned to that question that we just typed in. And then I also go through and I concatenate my data that is in there, and I can roll that stuff up to aggregations at whatever levels I want. Please feel free, in the link I'm going to share the community post that I have that will walk you through how I pass the data. But once again, all I'm doing is calling this automation endpoint that calls my Databricks endpoint. I then pass it the field values that I want. And that, my friends, is how you end up being able to call one of these wonderful Databricks large language models through a REST API that we implement through an automation. By calling the advanced connection rather than by calling just a pure REST API, I get that implementation where, as I make changes to the data and do selections, it automatically refires for the end user without them having to take any other actions, because it's simply using our advanced automation.